Greetings, welcome. So this is going to be a special video because today is Easter, so I decided to do a special Easter video. It'll be a short sermon, to do something new. So I'm just going to read two passages from the Bible. The first one will be Colossians 2:14. So here in Colossians chapter 2, verse 14, it says, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross. So obviously it's talking about Jesus Christ. So when Jesus Christ died on the cross, he took the entire law, the entire Old Testament law, all of those ordinances, and he just nailed it to the cross. So the law got nailed to the cross. And that law, the law was not helping us. The law was not helping the Jews. The law was just telling the Jews, you're sinners. That's all the law does. The law just accuses. Just like Satan accuses you, that's what the law does. The law just accuses you. It just tells you you're wrong, you're a sinner. It doesn't necessarily tell you how to fix the problem. The law just accuses you. It convicts you of the sin. So under the law, you could not be saved in the biblical sense. I mean, in the go to heaven under the law. The best you could do, the best the Jews could do, was offer temporary sacrifices with the blood of bulls and goats that were temporarily remit their sins and allow them to go into Abraham's bosom. But to actually go to heaven, that's why Jesus Christ had to die on the cross. He had to pay for all those sins, the past, present, and future sins. And those Jews that were in Abraham's bosom, they couldn't go up to heaven until that happened. And that was it. None of us could go to heaven if Jesus hadn't died on the cross. It's the most, basically you could say the most important day for us. Biblically, the rest of the Bible, your faith, none of it matters if Jesus Christ didn't die on the cross and if he didn't resurrect. If that isn't true, then none of this matters. It's not important. Then if that's wrong, then you could call the whole Bible into question. So that's why it's such an important event. That's why Easter, or Passover, it's better to use the word Passover, actually. I won't go into the differences between the etymologies of those two words, but well, I'll call it Passover. If that didn't happen, then this wouldn't. Then our faith would be, it wouldn't matter at all. So that's why it's this. So this verse is very important. It says, "Blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us," because so the law just accuses, and Jesus just nailed it to the cross. So. And that's very important because since the law wasn't saving us, and he just nailed it. And the problem is we often try to go back to the law. We often try to go back and do works and try to earn our salvation, but he already died. You just accept it. So we're already saved. So we can't earn that salvation through our works because we're trying to follow the law. It's like, what's the point of following the law? The law was bad. That's why he had to nail us to the cross. It wasn't helping anybody. It was just accusing us. That was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way of nailing it to his cross. So it's been nailed. It's been crucified. So don't go back to the old ways. Don't go back to the law. Don't try to follow the law. Don't try to be a Pharisee. Following some list of ordinances because it just that's what Jesus got rid of. He destroyed those ordinances. He nailed them to the cross. That's what's important to understand here. The next passage I wanted to read was actually out of Hebrews chapter 10. Yeah, Hebrews chapter 10, verses 2 through 4. For then would they not have ceased to be offered, because that the worshippers once purged should have no more conscience of sins, But in those sacrifices, there is a remembrance again made of sins every year, for it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sins. It's true. So in the Old Testament, you know, the Jews would sacrifice these bulls and these goats, and that was like a temporary thing, you know, temporary remission of sins. And if they followed the law, then they can go to Abraham's bosom, which is, you know, basically, you know, that might be where Catholics get their idea of purgatory from, actually. So every lie is based on some truth. And, you know, that's where they were. But then when Jesus died, you know, that's it. They were free. They couldn't go to heaven. They were waiting. And then when Jesus died, then finally they can go to heaven. They weren't allowed to go to heaven because they're not technically sinless. Those bloods and the blood of bulls and goats, that was okay. That was kind of like, you know, they're following God's law. That was temporarily taking those sins away. But when Jesus died, that's when those sins were finally paid for. They weren't paid for. So yeah, that's what happened here. So the bulls and the goats, that was just temporary. It even tells you in verse 4, for it is not possible the blood of bulls and goats should take away sins. Like, we needed Jesus. You need Jesus. Your best works don't do anything. That's what, like, non-Christians should understand, and Christians too, is that your works aren't going to save you. You're not going to stand before God and tell him, like, oh, I have these amazing works. Like, he's not going to listen. That's not important to God. You have to prove to him, like, you just trust in Jesus. That's it. Also, one thing I'd like to point out here, it's very interesting. I just realized this while reading. It says, for it is not possible that the blood of bulls and goats should take away sins. So it's specifically saying the blood of bulls and goats. Well, Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God. So it's interesting. It's almost prophetic because it's saying bulls and goats can't, but it doesn't say anything about a lamb. It specifically doesn't say anything about the blood of the lamb or anything like that. No, it's almost like, it's interesting. It's almost like prophetic. It's telling, like, it specifically excludes mentioning lambs because, you know, Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God. So yeah, I just thought that was very interesting while reading this. But yeah, this is just a very short video. I just wanted to, you know, just remind people that, like Jesus Christ, you know, Jesus Christ died on the cross. And so that's really the most important event, I'd say, of the Christian year, really. I mean, if you want to, you know, we don't have that many holidays, but this is definitely the most important one, because nothing else matters if this didn't happen. If this event didn't happen, then your sins aren't forgiven, and pretty much calls the entire Bible into question. So yeah. So this is meant to be, you know, kept short. So just remember, like, don't go back to your old ways. Don't go back to your old ways, the old sins, the old ways. Just remember that the law was crucified. The law is crucified. So don't go back to the law. Don't try to follow some strict set of rules. You want to have a good fellowship with Jesus, yes, but you know, you don't want to get, like, legalistic. Yeah, definitely don't want to get legalistic. So yeah, that's it. So yeah, see you next time. I'll be continuing my series on hell. I think I got two more videos. I'll be posting those. Yeah, see you next time.